Mr. Vice President, how many times have you ever spoken to your son about his overseas business dealings?
I've never spoken to my son about his overseas business dealings.
Ask the right questions.
Media has never turned down a chance to smear the Republicans with whatever rumor or half-baked scandal that was presented to them. We've seen them discredit themselves over and over when they prematurely blast out a story that was crafted to fit a narrative. For example, Covington, Jussie Smollett, the Russian spy story, or more recently, the story about a girl who claimed bullies cut her dreads off. But then it turned out that she made the whole thing up. That didn't stop them from breathlessly reporting the story to advance their narrative. Yeah, it turns out she made up the whole thing, and of course the media wasn't nearly as interested in reporting the truth. Which is exactly why we call them the drive-by media. I often pose the question to people on Twitter, when was the last time you remember our media pursuing a Democrat scandal? People rarely respond, but if they do, they always point to Clinton without realizing that the media defended Clinton. They attacked the whistleblower, and they smeared the independent counsel that was investigating Bill Clinton.
When someone drives, as one House Judiciary Committee member put this some weeks ago, a truck bomb up to the steps of the Capitol and just dumps it on them. Now, this is politically a very violent action for Ken Starr to leave this on them weeks before an election.
Pretend for a moment that the Starr report is a balanced, judicious presentation. It's not. It is a partisan prosecutor with some zealous aides who's trying to make a case against a guy he despises.
Did this report have to be that detailed, that explicit? I mean, you cringe when you read it. Does Congress need it? Do the American people need to hear it? Should the president be subjected to that kind of embarrassment?
What does Ken Starr do now, and do you think he'll be investigated?
This report, it is so salacious. It is so graphic. There will be many people who will feel it's disgusting, wonder what they'll tell their children. It could be a backlash against Ken Starr.
It seems that when a Republican is in office, the media loves investigations and holding truth to power. But when a Democrat takes office, they change their mission to defending that president and discrediting their critics. Even though we have a Republican administration, we're seeing that strategy play out right now. As negative attention has focused on the Democrat candidate Joe Biden, the media has turned the tables and began demonizing and discrediting the critics. Instead of digging into this story and holding truth to power, they're simply circling the wagons and attacking anybody who speaks of this scandal as some sort of crazy conspiracy theorist or just plain wacko.
They're not only dealing with impeachment, but they're dealing with this new line of attack regarding his son, which of course has been
disproven repeatedly.
When? It needs to be investigated before it can be disproven. We've heard left-wing activists in the media repeating this claim over and over, but we still have no idea why Joe Biden's son was given a position on the board of an energy company for which he had zero experience and paid $600,000 a year. Are we supposed to believe that it's just a coincidence that he gets this position while his father is vice president? Are we supposed to just move on when that same father uses his office as vice president to get the prosecutor who was investigating that company fired?
Wrong.
What makes things even worse for the media is that when Joe Biden was asked about this curious arrangement, Joe Biden lied and claimed that he had never spoken to his son about the company.
Mr. Vice President, how many times have you ever spoken to your son about his overseas business dealings?
I've never spoken to my son about his overseas business dealings.
Ask the right questions.
We now know that's just not true. Hunter admitted that they spoke about the company during an interview in The New Yorker. Not only do we know that Joe did talk to his son about this company, but now a new photo has surfaced showing Joe, his son, and Devon Archer, who served on the board of that very Ukrainian company. Biden lied, yet there seems to be zero interest in the media to hold truth to power. Or how about Joe and Hunter's dealings in China, where once again we see Hunter getting paid big bucks and sitting on the board of a company where he has zero experience? No smoke there, not at all. I mean, everybody knows that no serious journalist would want to look into this story.
How do you do that? If you have facts on your side, mm-hmm. if the story has been disproven time and time again, but you still have a bunch of, you know, wackos out there who believe this nonsense.
That's funny because I remember MSNBC, CNN, and the other networks claiming that Trump called immigrants animals in an infestation. That's been debunked since 2017, yet keeps appearing and reporting in the media. I'm still wondering what facts have been disproven. Joe Biden lied, that's a fact. His son was getting paid big bucks to be on a board of a company he had zero experience in, that's a fact. How many of you have gotten paid for a job, much less the big bucks, for a non-entry-level job that you had no experience in? Why was Hunter on that board, and what part did Joe Biden play in that? Any serious, real journalist would ask that question. But these fakes only seem interested in deflecting and burying the story. You can find the same sort of horrific clown show over at CNN, where they brought on disgraced liar Andrew McCabe to bash Trump and his supporters who might have questions about Joe Biden's dealings in Ukraine and China. And keep in mind, this is a guy that has somehow, up to this point, avoided prison time for lying to investigators.
You were one of the top officials who made sure the Russia investigation was opened. You were at the top levels. They're investigating you and your colleagues. Do you find Bill Barr's travels problematic? Top levels, they're investigating you and your colleagues. Do you find...
As she's talking about McCabe's role in opening the erroneous and now disproven Russian collusion investigation into Trump, the light on him fades and he seems to turn to a black shadow. How poetic.
Is Bill Barr doing this for the sole purpose of pursuing Trump's conspiracies? Debunked multiple conspiracy theories being spread by this president and his allies in the right-wing media.
What a surprise. The Democrat-related scandal with tons of unanswered questions is simply a conspiracy theory. The now thoroughly debunked conspiracy theories about Trump being a Russian agent and stealing the election, still apparently a topic to constantly reference and keep alive. This is just more proof of what we're up against. The Democrats and their media will stop at nothing to make sure that Trump either loses the election or never even gets a chance to run. And that's kind of scary because if these people get power back, watch out because they're not going to stop at Trump. They're going to come for all of us. If you want to help me in this fight against the DNC media, please hit that like button, share this video, and subscribe. If you want to help this channel survive and grow, consider subscribing to me on Patreon or Subscribestar. You can also send a donation over PayPal. You can find all the links in the description or the pinned comment. Thanks for watching and keep coming back.